Hi friends, welcome back to my channel and a very special welcome if you're new here. My name is Jen, I'm a certified weight loss and nutrition coach and it's Friday. So on Fridays, we talk all about my week, my weigh-in and the Weight Watchers workshop topic. So if you're excited, give this video a big huge thumbs up. Make sure you're subscribed, your bell notification is turned on because I do upload 5 videos every single week. And Friday, like I said, we always talk about my weigh-in, my week, and the workshop topic. Don't forget to check out the description box down below where I will link nutrition coaching. I do offer personalized to you macros and calories. Highly recommend. This is how I have lost and maintained a 140-pound weight loss. I also offer one-on-one coaching for accountability to ask your questions or talk with me directly. Links and discounts to my favorite things and my Facebook group. Come join us there. It's free, it's supportive, and we would love to have you is also down in that description box. So let's jump into my week, my weigh-in, and the workshop topic. Friday, friends. I hope you had an absolutely amazing, amazing week. I really feel like I'm 100% back in my groove. I had a really, really busy week from the weekend all the way through today has just been insanely busy. I did share quite a few updates in my Wednesday's What I Eat in a Day. So if you missed that video, I'll make sure that it is linked down below for you. You'll get lots of life updates and things that have happened over the course of this last week. But needless to say, it's been a very, very, very busy week, but it's also been a really good week. I got in all of my workouts this week, and tomorrow is kind of an exciting day. I'm actually heading to what is called Pikachu Peak here in Arizona with my boot camp group. It literally is a peak, the top of a mountain that you climb up to. Unfortunately, due to my recent cosmetic surgery, I'm not going to be able to do the last half of the hike because it involves a lot of gloves and ropes and pulling yourself up the side of the mountain, and I'm unable to use my upper body to that extent right now. But I am going to do the first half of the hike, which is about 4 to 5 miles, and then I'm just going to enjoy the scenery while the rest of the group hikes to the top, and then afterwards we're all going to go have breakfast. So it's going to be a really fantastic way to start my Saturday. Make sure that you follow me over on Instagram and that you're in my Facebook group because I will post lots of pictures there so you can see how that hike went, how I did on the hike. It's going to be probably one of the longest and most intense hikes that I've done so far, and honestly, I'm pretty excited about it. I also got in all my days of boot camp, lifted weights, just really had a great, successful, active week. I'm feeling really, really good. I would say other than the tightness of my incisions, especially my back incision, I feel pretty normal. I feel, I would say, like 98% back to my normal self. It gets better and better every single day, and I'm able to do more and more in my workouts. Actually, this week was kind of a big NSV for me at boot camp. I was able to do mountain climbers, and I haven't been able to do those since I had my cosmetic surgery. So I am, like I said, getting back into the swing of things, getting back to normal. I'm going to give myself just a couple more months for my body to fully heal before I go back to full activity, but I'd say 98% is looking pretty darn good. I did eat out quite a few times this week as well. We had my boot camp girls night where we went to the Barbie movie. Spoiler alert, the Barbie movie is really, really good. I loved it. There was so much underhanded humor. It was fantastic. If you haven't seen it, highly recommend. Troy and I ate out a couple of times as well, just due to the busyness of our week. I mean, sometimes life happens and we end up eating out more than normal. And I still feel like overall, I made really, really good food choices and did my best to not only stay on plan, but also get in my protein. So I'd rate my week really about a 9 out of 10. Before I talk about this week's weigh-in though, I want to discuss this week's Weight Watchers workshop topic because it's another really good one that everybody needs to hear. And this is, are the people in your life helping or hurting your progress? This is definitely a question that we all need to ask ourselves. Are the people that we're surrounding ourselves with, is our community, are the people we're following on social media helping or hurting our progress? Family, friends, coworkers, people you follow on social media, they can all either have a really positive or negative impact, not only in your weight loss journey, on your mental health, but just in your life in general. take some time to think about who you let into your life and try some of these tips. Number one, list the people you talk to, listen to, read, or see most often. Are they friends, family, or coworkers, podcasters, news anchors, TV hosts, or social media accounts, bloggers, and writers? Number two, explore your top few. Think about their tone, messaging, and how they make you feel, especially about your journey. And number three, categorize them based on whether they help you reach your goals or not. Who could you connect with more? Maybe the IG influencer who shares real life's ups and downs of weight loss, or maybe the coworker who gets you to walk during lunch. Who could you interact with less? The friend who constantly talks about trendy crash diets, or the podcaster who stresses you out about your health? Number four, recalibrate. Can someone on your more list replace time with one on the less list, or can you find someone new to swap in? Invite your coworker to try a workout instead of a diet-obsessed friend. Listen to a new podcast recommended by your favorite IG influencer. And lastly, number five, plan exactly what you'll do, when, where, and how you'll make it happen. It's really easy to get into a habit or a routine to hang out with the same people, whether they serve us or not in our life and in our weight loss journey. We also don't usually take a lot of time to curate our social media feed, our Instagram feed, our Facebook groups that we're in, our Connect feed. We want to make sure that we curate those again to people who serve us. I really like the approach of thinking about the people you need to spend less time with and the people you need to spend more time with. I know for me, the fact that I have a Facebook group that has almost 30,000 members is really, really beneficial for a positive, healthy place to be on your weight loss journey. We don't allow negativity. Everything is positive. There's some amazing tips and tricks that are shared in my Facebook group. So again, if you're not part of it, it's free, it's supportive, and it would be a really good place to put your energy for a positive community. Make the changes you need to make to be more successful. Curate your feed, curate your friends, your family. Don't spend time with coworkers that don't contribute to a positive workplace for you. Choose your friends, the ones that are really going to benefit you on your weight loss journey. And with family, it's a little bit harder. With spouses, it's a little bit harder. But that's when you actually sit down and you have a conversation with those people and let them know what you need from them in order to be successful. Our loved ones, our friends, our family, our spouses, our friends, they want us to be successful. They want us to succeed. And if they don't, they're definitely not your friends or people you should be spending time with. So they should listen to you, absorb what you're saying, and really help you reach your goals. As always, there's three amazing fast facts from Weight Watchers. Number one, when it comes to our weight and wellness journey, the people around us matter. Number two, this is true for the people we interact with both directly and indirectly. And number three, noticing how people impact our journey can help us prioritize time with those who support our goals. Again, less time with these people, more time with these people. You have full control over who you spend your time with for the most part. I mean, you might be married to someone or have family, but again, that's when you sit down and have that conversation on what you need from them, and hopefully they love you enough to support you in your journey. But your friends, even your coworkers, your social media feed especially, you can really curate that to benefit you most. Make sure you're surrounding yourself with like-minded people who will help you reach your goals, not hinder them. As always, I really like this workshop topic. I think that this 4-week series from Weight Watchers about people you surround yourself with on your journey is really, really important, and maybe not something we think about that could really be either helping or hindering us along the way. So I really appreciate that Weight Watchers has focused on this for the last few weeks. Now let's jump into my weigh-in. I know that that's what a lot of you tune into this Friday video for. Last week, I actually maintained my weight to the ounce, which I was really grateful for. I had gained a couple pounds, lost some of that, and then kind of have maintained that sense. If you didn't know, I do weigh myself daily, usually in the morning and at night. The scale doesn't have a negative effect on me, so for me, I truly just use that as data. I like to see how has my workout, the foods that I've been eating, how much water I've been drinking, whether I ate out or cooked my meals, how that affects my weight. And I know that weight fluctuation is totally normal, so it doesn't ever affect me in a negative way or a positive way. Again, I simply use it for data. This week, my weight did a lot of this, which is pretty normal for me. A lot of my fluctuation is based on exercise. If my body is really sore, my weight immediately goes up. I can literally gain 3 pounds overnight if I do a really hard workout, especially a lower body or leg workout. My weight can just shoot up the next day, which I know I didn't gain 3 pounds overnight. It's simply just a weight fluctuation. But at the end of the week, when I actually weighed in this morning, I am down 0.4. So last week I maintained my weight. This week I'm down just a tiny bit, and I'll take it. I consider that more like a maintenance, which is kind of what I'm trying to do while I continue recovering from cosmetic surgery. So again, I can see where my body lands once I am fully recovered. Speaking of body and recovery, I am going to go back and have another body scan in November. November will be 1 year since my last body scan and 6 months since my cosmetic surgery, which means I should be fully healed and the real results should be there. So I'm really excited to see what that body scan shows 1 year later. So stay tuned. I'll share all of that with you guys, of course, but I'm feeling really good about my 0.4 loss. I'm feeling good about maintaining my weight. The fact that I ate out a lot this last week, that I had several events where I didn't have control over food. I feel really good about losing 0.4 pounds. Now I want to hear from you guys. How was your week? Did you gain? Did you lose? Let me know how you feel about curating both your in-person and social media environment to serve you better. And of course, if you enjoyed another weigh-in, give this video a big thumbs up. Subscribe if you're not. Turn your bell on. I do a weigh-in every Friday. And like I said, I do upload 5 videos every single week. Don't forget to check out the description box down below for nutrition coaching. Highly recommend personalized macros and calories. Links and discounts to my favorite things. And like I mentioned, please come join my Facebook group. Follow me over on Instagram for positive and a really supportive, loving community. Of course, we'd love to have you in both platforms. Thank you again for watching. Happy Friday, friends. Happy weekend. And I'll see you in tomorrow's grocery haul. Bye.